welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make the most beautiful, most delicious dip ever, guacamole. Yay, guacamole. I love guacamole. As a lot of you guys know, I'm always in the search of the perfect avocado. I find them beautiful. I think they taste amazing and they're super good for you. Guacamole is one of those dips that it's super easy to make, and everybody has their own way to make it. It's very simple. You only need a handful of ingredients, and then you have guacamole. But although it's super simple to make, it is super delicious, and it goes with almost everything. The ingredients you're going to need are 2 large avocados and 2 small, they're like medium-sized avocados. A handful of cilantro. Now, this is about 1/2 cup chopped up. We might use it all, we might not. It just really depends on how it goes. That goes for everything. We might use more, we might use less. We'll see as the process goes. We're going to use 2 limes. And here we have 1/2 jalapeno chopped up without the seeds or veins. And this is optional. I like it for the jalapeno flavor, and it does give a little bit of a kick, but you could totally omit this if you don't want any spice or you just don't like the taste of jalapeno. Salt and pepper. First things first, I want to show you how to pick a good avocado. This is a pretty normal avocado. Honestly, the color sometimes does not matter. What you want to do is go off of this. So when you remove this little pit or stem that they have, you want them to look like this. I don't know if you guys can see. It looks yellowish. You don't want it to look green, and you also don't want it to look black. I'm going to show you how to cut an avocado. A lot of people are scared to cut avocados. I don't blame you. So what you want to do is, so you want to make a slit here, just like so, and just keep turning the avocado. Let the knife do the work, and then you meet again. You grab it like this, and you spin, just like so, and you open it up. It's a pretty decent avocado. This is what I like to do. I make slits. I don't go all the way through to where it pierces the skin. I just go right in to where it'll go all the way down to the bottom, but it doesn't pierce it. And this just makes the process of smashing the avocado a lot easier than to have to try to smash the big old piece of the avocado. Okay, let's do another one. So you make the incision right in the middle. You spin the avocado so you don't lose any fingers or thumbs. Did you guys hear that there was that crazy article going on with, they were calling it avocado thumb because people in, I want to say it was England, they were slicing off their thumbs trying to open avocados or take out the pit. That's pretty scary. So this is a beautiful avocado. Just look at this. Oh, such a beauty. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to take the pit. So you tuck your fingers or your thumb down here, and you just want to gently get the pit, pierce the pit, and you turn the pit. The pit should slide right away. Now, if it's not, it's probably because the avocado wasn't quite ready. You leave it on the pit, and then I just pop it off. Now, this is what it looks like. And then you just want to slice the avocado. Now, as you can see, I'm not piercing through the skin. I'm just slicing through to try to make it easier for when I smash the avocado. It comes out right out, and it's a lot easier. Now with the spoon, a large spoon preferably, you want to go right in between the skin and the avocado, and it comes right out. And you're going to do that with all of them. Okay, so now I have all the avocados cubed and in the bowl. Now I'm going to mash with my fork just by pressing down. And how much you want to mash, it really comes down to how you like your avocado. I used to eat my guacamole kind of chunky like this, like you see it here. I would only mash very little, and then that would be it, because I really like the chunks of avocados. And I like it a lot smoother now. So I'm going to mash it all out. Now I'm going to mash all this down, and I'll be right back. At this point, I have all the avocados smashed. As you can see, they're pretty smashed. There's still a few chunks in there, but not too much. Now it's pretty thick. That's not how I want it. I want it a lot smoother than that. Now, if this is how you like your guacamole, this is the point that you add the cilantro, the onions, everything else, and then you're set. But this is what I like to do to mine. So before I add water, I'm going to add the limes, because they are gonna give it some liquid, and it's gonna also, I guess, emulsify the guacamole. Now, this is how you use the lime or the citrus squeezer. So a lot of people do this. But if you do it like that, a lot of the juice gets stuck in here because this does not go through. So this is what you want to do. This is the proper way to put it in. This will go into the lime, and therefore you will squeeze. Now I usually cover it so it doesn't splash everywhere, and I turn it so it just drains down on the sides instead of squirting everywhere. So I'm going to put in the four limes, and then I'll taste. If it needs more, then we'll adjust. So I just added the two limes, and as you can see, it has smoothed it out some. Now, before I add the water, I'm going to add the cilantro. Actually, I'm going to add the onion first. And this I like to do little by little, because, just because. So I'm gonna grab a handful. I think I'm gonna grab more. Okay. So this was about half a cup chopped up. Okay, so I added about a half of that half. Mixing it in. I feel that it's going to need more just by looking at it. Now, purple onion, it's a little stronger. I don't know if stronger is the word. I don't know. It has a good zippity zip. And it's super healthy for you. Everything that's dark in color like this or purple is really good for you. I'm almost using the half of onion that was. And it's half of, it's a quarter of a small onion, but it was about half a cup chopped up. So almost. These will be fine. Going to add the cilantro. I like to go in with the cilantro. It adds a lot of flavor, and it's super good for you. It detoxifies your body, helps you get rid of the heavy metals in your body. So cilantro is totally your friend. I'm going to add a little more, because that's just how I roll. I'm going to add the jalapeno, and I'm gonna grab little by little and see how much I want to add. I'm going to add about that much. It's probably about half of what I chopped up. I'm going to mix it in. At this point, it's looking good to me. So I haven't tried it yet, but I used about most of the half a cup of onion, most of the cilantro, half of the jalapeno. Now, at this point, I'm going to add some of the water. I have a little bit of water. It's probably like a quarter cup in here. And I'm just gonna add little by little because I wanna emulsify it. Now, like I said before, if you don't want to add water, you like yours thick like that, just omit this step. I'm not a heavy dipper. Like, my husband and my son are very heavy dippers. I'm not, or at least I don't think I am. Okay, it's a lot smoother, but I feel like I can still go a little smoother than this. So I'm going to add a little more. Okay, this is the texture that I like. This is the smoothness I like. It's still dippable. See, it's still thick, but it's a lot smoother. And it goes a little bit longer. It lasts a little, well, not in this household it doesn't, but you get a little more now that it's smoothed out, I think. Okay, we haven't added salt or pepper. So at this point, I'm going to grab a big pinch of salt. Because like potatoes, avocado needs its salt. So I'm going to do a big pinch and I'm going to mix it in. Actually, I'm going to add the pepper. And I'm doing fresh cracked black pepper. Doing a few crinks here. If you're doing the pepper that is already grinded, that comes in a little container, I would go differently with that because it almost has a different taste and potency. So I would do it different. I would add little by little. Now, when I try it, I don't like to try it with a chip till I know that for sure it's ready, because the chips tend to have a little bit of salt. So that will throw off the flavor. I think it needs definitely more salt. So I'm gonna do another pinch. Maybe not so big of a pinch. Medium sized pinch. I feel like it needs more lime. I'm going to add another lime. Now the lime does help keep it from going brown. None of my guacamoles have ever gone brown on me. Yet, I mean, we do eat them quite fast. But it has gone like all day without turning brown. So I know the lime preserves it. So I'm adding another lime. This will make it the third lime. And they're a pretty good size. Now, like I said, this is just down to preference. I like mine really limey. I might add the rest of the cilantro. So yeah, I think I'm going to add the rest of the cilantro. I might add some more of the jalapeno. In fact, I'm gonna add the whole jalapeno. And I think I'm good on the onion. So now I'm going to mix. Now you can also use serrano peppers. You don't have to use jalapeno if you don't choose to. You can also use serranos. Serranos are a little bit spicier. They're very delicious in flavor though. Okay, it's looking really good. And it's a texture I like. Smooth. It's a smooth operator. Time to try it again. I think we need a little bit more pepper. Maybe a little more salt. And I'm going to add more of the onion. So I pretty much used most of the onion. There's not much left in there. So to my preference, it's almost a whole quarter of that small onion. And I think we're done. It was pretty simple. This is great to take to parties, for your barbecues. The 4th of July is coming around, so you can totally make this. You can do a 7-layer dip. It's really, you can do so much with it. Let me try it. I'm really pleased with it. So we used pretty much everything. We added another lime, 2 pinches of salt. So probably, and this is pink Himalayan salt. So probably about a teaspoon of salt. I'm just guesstimating here, so definitely thread lightly when you're doing it at home. Okay, and now our guacamole is done. It's so good. It's so delicious. Now we get to try it with some chips. It's so good. You get the zinginess from the purple onion. The jalapeno only gives a flavor. It is not spicy at all. It has like a, it's more like a, it's just the flavor of the jalapeno that I can taste. I don't feel that it's spicy at all. At all. Aside from the limes, making it fresh, giving it that freshness and deliciousness, it's also helping the guacamole from going brown. It's a double whammy with the lime. Now the cilantro, I mean, cilantro love. Hashtag cilantro love. Cilantro makes everything better. So it's just, it's really good. I know that you guys will like this recipe. This goes good on everything. Taquitos, tacos, quesadillas, with chips. It's just perfect. Guacamole is to Mexicans what hummus is to vegans. It is that good, people. You guys will love it. You guys will love it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. I'm Sahar Belle, and this is the Learning Everything with Sahar Belle. I'll see you next time. Bye.